Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. In this week's episode, I have a special guest, Dominic Batstone, who's going to introduce to us how we can customize some fields within Azure DevOps within our tasks and use Power Automate to make those fields do more for us. So tune in. Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. In this week's episode, we're going to be welcoming a very special guest, Dominic Batstone. Welcome, Dominic.
Thanks, April. Yep, I'm Dominic Batstone. I'm a Customer Success Account Manager Developer, which is probably the longest title in Microsoft, I think. My role is basically helping customers unblock themselves, innovate, and increase velocity.
Really excited to have you on the DevOps Lab. We're both located in the UK. We're both in the Microsoft Cycling Club. We're not going to talk about cycling today, though, unfortunately. Fortunately, maybe for those watching. But we're going to talk about using Power Automate to calculate our fields in Azure DevOps. So, Dominic, why don't you go ahead and take it away?
Cool. So, remember in the old days when we had like TFS on-prem and in the clouds? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's quite a while now. But basically, that had the calculated fields feature. And when DevOps came out, it's like, well, where has that feature gone? And we used to use it to sort of calculate hours and things before, you know, Scrum points came in. Mm-hmm. So we're thinking like, well, how can we do this? And then Power Automate comes along, and with its connectors to DevOps, now we can do it. So do you want me to show you how to do it?
Absolutely. I have used Power Automate so many times to hook into Azure DevOps. So I'm really excited to see you introduce this to us.
Cool. Okay. So what I'm going to do first is go and create an inherited process. So this is in Azure DevOps. And let's create an inherited process from the Agile. Let's call it a calc process. Cool. And if we go into this, I'm going to update a task because that's where we generally do our work. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to hide the original planning effort fields. Okay, so I'm going to add three new fields. Let's have starting number or number. It's got to be an integer or decimal. And let's make it required and give it a value of 10, for example. So we'll add that field. And then let's add another one. Let's call it a used number. And again, that's got to be an integer. And let's give that a default value of 0 to start with. So when we create a task, that will have 0 to start with, because obviously we haven't used any of whatever it is. It could be hours, it could be anything. Okay. And then finally, let's add remaining on spell. And let's make that an integer. And let's have that as a default value of 10, I think. Yes. Okay. Cool. So that's our three new fields added. So I think we'll go and create a new project now for this one.
Okay. And this is all done from within the organizational settings.
Yes, it is. So we'll do a new team project. Let's call it calc related fields. And let's choose private. Okay. Can you see here it's got the process already pre-selected?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, now what I'm going to do, let's create a new task. So new work item, task. And you'll see that there's our three fields here.
Okay.
So let's call it our first, and spell again, there it is. Firsty task, that'll do.
That is good, I like that.
Yeah, sounds quite cool. Let's save. Excellent, so that's ready to go now. So let's go over to Power Automate, see what we can do there.
Okay.
Cool. So I'm going to go to my flows.
And now on these flows, I know there's a bunch that come out of the box that hook inherently to Azure DevOps. And is this one that you created from an existing connector, but created a customized flow?
Yeah, we'll just have a look at that in a second. So I'm going to create a new automated cloud flow. So it's be triggered when something happens, basically.
Awesome.
So let's call it cow key. And we can do a quick search for all the DevOps ones, for example. So if we scroll down here slowly, we don't want when a work aren't created, that's already happened. We want it when it's updated. Mm-hmm. So that'll be the trigger. So let's create that. So here's our first box we want to fill in. So if I find my organization, there we are. And the project name, which we called it ooh, calculated fields with the lowercase f. I can tell I've done this before. And let's restrict it to task. Don't have to, but I will do.
Gives you the ability to get more granular in your workflow.
Indeed, yeah. And then we'll add another step. So we want to actually get the information from that previous work item that's been triggered. So let's search for DevOps again. Let's scroll down. Let's see. Get work item detail. So notice this says premium. Mm-hmm. This means it's not one of the free ones. So you have to check your licensing to see what you have, basically. Of course, let's choose my organization again. Calculated fields. And we'll leave the work item type blank as is, because we're already guessing the item from the previous one. So all we need now is the ID. And there it is, helpfully populated for us. That's quite cool.
Good.
And then the final step is to update that item we've just got. So let's search again for DevOps. And we want to update a work item. And again, and this shows how easy Power Automate is, because, you know, this is like amazing. There's code going on behind here, but I'm literally not doing much at all, to be honest.
Absolutely. It's pretty much no code at this point. It's filling in some identity fields. It's pulling those metrics through. You're able to use the unique ID to qualify each of those fields that you're populating Azure DevOps and process them through.
Cool. So we'll just quickly show the advanced options. Mm-hmm. And then, what is it? Remaining none is the one we want to update. And then we have an expression which we want to put into here, mm-hmm. which will be a subtraction. So we're taking one number away from another, basically.
Okay.
So let me pull this out. Copy. Just scroll down a little bit. Here we go. Expression. So there's a little test, see if we can actually remember what we called the fields. I cannot. So we've got starting number and we've got used number. Used number. So let's go to DevOps and let's say we've used two of this number, basically. So let's save. Now in the background, that should be triggering my flow. It does take maybe a minute or so. Mm-hmm. So let's go over there and see what's happening. So we see it ran successfully. That's really good news. Let's go back to DevOps and see what's happened. Okay, so we've got 10 and we took two off. That remains 8. That's good. So that worked. So I suppose in the past, what I was trying to do when we had TFS was when we estimated things by hours. Mm-hmm. So this is quite a good use case. There's probably others, but April, what's your experience around estimating with hours?
So I think we tend to advise people to not estimate with hours, but this is a fantastic capability to customize the fields that works for your project that you're working on. And the reason why we tell people not to estimate with hours is because when you estimate with an hour, what might take me 2 hours might take another engineer, developer, 8 hours or 10 hours. It's hard because it's hard to estimate those hours because people work very differently in different ways. So we like to do amount of effort. And a lot of the projects I've worked on, we used the amount of effort. We would say anything when we're doing our project estimation, task estimation, anything over an eight was the entire sprint cycle. A 5 was high, kind of that medium high. 3 was fairly easy. And then we had 2 and 1. So one task might take you, a very short amount of time. So we used to use amount of hours and we used a Fibonacci sequence and anything that took over that amount of times. And sometimes people use cups of coffee, et cetera. Estimation's hard. And as we develop our sprint cycles, we have to kind of figure out what works best for us. But being able to customize these fields and automate that is fantastic because it gives us visibility in a project that works for us as in any project that we might be working on.
Cool. And of course, you don't just have to use number fields. It could be text, it could be dates, and people may be using DevOps for all sorts of different reasons, you know, using the APIs for all sorts of different use cases. So I think it's a really flexible way of doing things.
Absolutely, especially if you use a different type of field. Like you said, dates, you could use remaining days, almost like a countdown to when something, when the sprint's due, et cetera, when the task is due, gives you that visibility. Dominic, thank you so much. This was really cool to see a way we could automate something with a hook into Azure DevOps using Power Automate. So thank you for coming on the show. And we will put the links to Dominic's blog for you all to read as well.